Hi everyone, welcome to Lucid tutorials, and I hope you are doing well. Today I will show you how to combine shapes in Apple's Freeform app on macOS. If you are using an iPad or iPhone, you can still follow along and use the methods in this tutorial to achieve the same results on your iOS devices. In the Freeform app, you can combine shapes to create a new shape by uniting, intersecting, subtracting, and excluding. We'll examine the four options individually and see what effects you can create by using each option. If you have never used the Freeform app, I have already made a comprehensive tutorial on how to use it. You can watch it on my channel. And there are also tips and tricks tutorials. I will leave the links in the description box under this video. Let's get started with the first one, Unite Shapes. We have three shapes on this board from the People category in the Shapes library: blue, green, and red. Each shape or person is separated from the others. We want to make a single image by uniting them. The first step in uniting shapes is to select them by dragging your mouse pointer over them. Once you have your shapes selected, go to the Format menu, move your mouse over shapes and lines, and select Unite Shapes. This will combine the selected shapes into a single shape. Therefore, they lose their individuality and all become blue. Why not green or red color? How does the Freeform app choose the color? The Freeform app selects the color of the unified shape based on the color of the first shape added to the board. The first shape added to the board has a blue color. Therefore, the other two shapes will be blue when they are united. Let's add another shape to the board. I'll choose this leaf and change its color to green. This is the first leaf on this board. Next, I'll right-click on it and select Duplicate from the Context menu. One more time. Change the color of the second leaf to orange. And the third one will be yellow. Now, if I unite them, they will all have a green color. So, the color of the first shape added to the board will be chosen for the final shape. Now, let's try to unite overlapped shapes. I'll insert the beehive onto the board. And add a border by clicking on it. Selecting a border type. And changing its color to yellow. Next, I'll duplicate it by pressing and holding down the Option key, clicking on it, and dragging. One more time. The overlapping borders or areas will be eliminated by uniting the shapes. As a result, the three images become one single image. Let's try another shape. I imported the heart shape from the shape library. Duplicated it, added a border, changed their color, rotated them, and finally stacked them on top of one another. In the next step, I'll select them by dragging the mouse pointer over them and selecting Unite Shapes from the Format menu. As you can see, when you unite shapes, you take the overlapping areas and make them into one continuous shape. Now, the shape has only one color, affected by the color of the first shape we added to the board. However, if you don't like the blue color, you can change it to a different color by clicking on the formatting tool and selecting a different color. Suppose you don't want to eliminate the overlapping borders or areas and want to keep each shape in a different color. In that case, put them into a group. By the way, if you want to rotate a shape on your board, click on it to select it and hold down the Command key on your keyboard to get a double-headed curved arrow. Then you can rotate it clockwise or counterclockwise. The second option is intersect shapes. Intersecting shapes refer to creating a new shape from overlapping areas of two or more shapes. Therefore, only the overlapping area remains visible when you intersect two shapes. Graphic artists and designers use this method to create a new shape by combining two shapes. Let's look at some examples. I have added a square and a circle to the board by importing them from the shape library. I added borders to the shapes by clicking on them and selecting a border type from the formatting tools. Then I placed part of the circle on top of the square. To make a shape transparent, click on it to select it. Go to the Format menu and select Show Colors. If you don't see the color wheel, click on the icon in the top left corner. Next, drag the opacity slider to the left or right to adjust the color opacity. The first step to intersect shapes is to select them by dragging your mouse pointer over them. Next, go to the Format menu. Move your mouse pointer over Shapes and Lines and select Intersect Shapes. As you can see, overlapping areas have remained and the other areas have been removed. Next, we will try to form a diamond shape by combining two triangles. And finally, two hearts can be used to make flower petals shape. The third option is subtract shapes. Subtracting shapes in the Freeform app is a technique that involves removing one shape from another to create a new shape or design. This can be accomplished by using the subtract shapes tool in the app. When subtracting one shape from another, we will remove the overlapping areas. The Subtract Shapes tool removes the upper shape from the lower shape. Subtracting shapes in the Freeform app is a straightforward process that can be accomplished in a few simple steps. Here is how you can get started. First, I'll add two shapes to the board. A leaf and some flowers. I'll change the leaf color to green and the flowers to pink using the formatting tool. Next, I'll drag the flowers onto the leaf and select them by dragging the mouse pointer over them. I want to subtract the flowers from the leaf. I go to the Format menu, move the mouse pointer over shapes and lines, and select subtract shapes. Next, I will subtract a butterfly from the heart. And that's the effect I get. The fourth option is Exclude Shapes. In the Freeform app, the Exclude Shapes tool removes the overlapping area between the shapes. The area that is not overlapped will not be removed. You may ask, what's the difference between exclude and subtract? The Exclude Shapes tool excludes the overlapping area only and leaves the rest of the shape untouched. The Subtract Shapes tool subtracts the entire shape from the lower shape. I hope that this tutorial was helpful. If you learned something new from it, give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe to receive notifications of upcoming tutorials. Your support will encourage me to make more videos for you. Thank you for watching.